it's been
2 years and 3 months.
3 months. Where are you now? Where are you now? Where is your family now?
It's a long process. It's a healing process. There's a hole in your life that never goes away. I don't know if anger is the right word, but where part of the problem is, the military expresses a desire to help soldiers who may be struggling, and there are programs there. But we've talked to many soldiers over the last few years, and there is still a strong degree of judgment and stigma. So that that's unofficial, and if you talk to them, they say, "Oh no, we support them, and there's no penalty." But in real life, I don't believe that's true at all. And we all talk about the fact we've been at war in Afghanistan for 10 years, and of course that's not true. 1% of the population has been at war carrying the burden and the load for all of us. We all care. We all are concerned about it. We all talk about it, but our lives aren't any different. Nothing changes. There's no rationing. There's no Rosie the Riveters. Our lives go on completely unchanged. So it's 1% of the population that was at war for 10 years or 15 years. And I think that comes out in several different ways, contributing to the suicide epidemic that's occurring. It's not so much that society isn't supportive of them. I think they are. And when the issues are brought up to them, they're responsive, genuinely. But then we all go on with our lives, and they're left struggling. With suicide in general, there's always a component for any family experiencing that, an element of blaming yourself or searching for answers, or what could I have done, or could I have known, or could I have seen it coming, could I have prevented it. I mean, we told them 1,000 times how proud we are, how proud we were, how supportive, how much respect we had for what he was doing. Sometimes I ask myself, maybe I did that too much, maybe it made it difficult for him to talk about that. Maybe, was I too proud of him?
If you could talk to him today, what would you say?
I mean, ultimately, what I said to him many, many times, that I love him, tremendously proud of him, and still am. I mean, that hasn't changed one shred through this experience. And he knew that about all of the family. There's just no question in my mind. But I would tell him that again.